What is going on, guys? We are back with OT Round 2. This is Loser's Bracket Race Covers with Lioness. This is game 1. And really interesting to see a fortress on Lioness's side. I assume it's gonna be spin plus defog to make sure that hazards never go up for the Zard. And a Z move Coco and Scarf Keldeo is what I'm thinking. Race Covers has used this team before, but he changed it a bit. Before, he had a Z move. Okay, Lioness gets up rocks early, gets trapped by the Magnet Zone. Before, Ray had Z-move Jirachi when he used this team, but Jirachi can only be Z-move Happy Hour when it's shiny. So I think he changed it to Scarf Jirachi into Z-move Dagi. That's what I'm thinking here. And I don't really know why Ray Scarf is went for T-Bolt there, because I guess he just thought it would bring this to sturdy anyway. But I'm pretty sure this is Dev Fortress because it took the specs T-Bolt decently well. Should be specs. And now we see if this is DD or Bandit. Even if Lioness is Zard Y, it's gonna get walled by the packs, and if he's Zard X, he's gonna potentially get trapped by the Dagi if he evolves, so it's gonna be tough for him no matter which Zard he is. We see he is Bandit because that did a lot to the Fist Staff Helmet Tangrowth. He gets a 3-turn outrage, that means Magnezone is gonna be able to go for Flashkin and do a lot of damage to the Zygarde, but now Magnezone is in range to die from rocks. So Lioness can just go into his Zard here or into his Keldeo. Those are the only flash can resists he has. But yeah, since this Magnezone dies to rocks, Lioness is probably not really Lioness, Ray is probably gonna stay in and sack it off to either the Keldeo or the Zard here. As there's the Zard and staying in is also a fine play if it's Zard X, because it cannot DD up on you. It doesn't get a Spadef boost if it megas if it's Zard X, so like just spamming Flashkin will not let it set up for free. It does a lot, and you can also fish for Spadef drops, because Zard would have to get multiple DDs. If it's Scarf Dagi, Zard would have to get 2 DDs to outspeed it if it's X. I guess he could have gone for DD in regular form, but like I said, it still would have done a lot, and he could have gone a Spadef drop. So Pex comes out, it obviously walls the Charizard, there's a Toxic Spike. And Lioness is gonna spin here, and Ray is gonna try to Skull Burn the Fortress. He does get the Skull Burn first try, it definitely sucks, because the Fortress would have gotten, wouldn't been able to get a lot of leftovers back otherwise. Since Skull only does 7%, it wouldn't have done anything. Scald in the Thunder is nothing, and lefties would have cancelled that out. So he Volt Switch into Zyra, expecting a Toxic Spike. And he's probably gonna go for Outrage, that's the only move. Actually, he might just go for the ground move. But Ray's obviously gonna go into his Tangrowth just to scout what the Zygarde goes for. He doesn't lose anything from doing that. If Lioness doubles into Zard, like Ray's just what Ray can just say whatever, I just have my Toxic Specs to wall the Zard, so why would I care? And even if Lioness doubles again into Coco, at the moment, T-Spikes are up, so he can't really afford to make that play. And even if he made that play, he has a Mammoth Mine, and he has a Dougie, and most Cocos are physical these days, so the Helmet Tangrowth also wards that pretty well, or checks it pretty well. So yeah, Lioness is thinking about his play here. Ray Scarvis is obviously just gonna go into Tang. So yeah, on Lioness' side, it could be, like I said, Z-move Coco. Another option would be Munium Z, but I think the Mew is just lefties. Secondary Defogger. Like I talked about this earlier, you want to make sure that you don't have hazards on your side when you have a Zard, so Spin plus Defog makes sense. Doesn't have to be, but what makes sense to me. So he gets the Earthquake crit there, but it still doesn't 2-hit KO. Ray is free to click Giga Drain here. It should be able to pick off the Zygarde from 20%. And yeah, like I said, if he brings out the Zard, that's just a free Toxic Breaks for Ray. So nothing's lost from clicking Giga Drain. I assume that's a fast Mew on Lioness' side if it's a Will-O-Wisp Mew, like, no matter which Mew it is. If it's a offensive Mew, there's the obvious Zard, there's the obvious Giga Drain, and the Pex is gonna come out here, so it's, Yeah, exactly. He was either gonna root stare or double into fortress to get rid of a toxic spy. So Ray can just go for Skull to the weakness a bit. But I was talking about the Mamoswine. The Mamoswine would look a bit scary, but I assume that the Mew has, if it's Will-O-Wisp, it's gonna be faster than a Mamo, that would be able to burn that. So yeah, Toxic Spice are gonna go back up here as he volts out and probably into Band Zygarde again. This time you might go for Outrage because at the time it's into it KO range. And even if Ray goes into Jirachi after, it would still take a good chunk. And that's Lioness' best way of putting offensive pressure on Ray. There's the Tangrowth and there's the Outrage. Bob lives on 9%, so we will see if Ray is gonna sack his Tang. Tang would be nice for physical Coco, but he still has a Mamo and a Dougie, so it's not the end of the world for Ray. And if it's Jirachi's offensive, it would take a lot from Outrage, so you might not want to let Jirachi take a hit. I'm thinking how Lioness can win this. Coco's gonna like U-turn around later to weaken them. Yeah, okay, so he does sack off the Tang to get rid of the Zygarde. So Coco can like U-turn around, but the T-Swag is gonna be annoying. I assume Ray's gonna try to go to something that doesn't let him spin the T-Swag away. Mamoswine should be able to kill the fortress from there. Yeah, I think he doesn't lose too much from going Mamoswine here. It beats the Coco. If he goes Keldeo, he just goes into his Toxapex. If he goes Fortress, he should just be able to kill it with the Earthquake, especially because it's Spadef. Even if it was Fist Def, it should die from the range of the ad. It's pretty low. And if he goes Mew, you probably also go Toxapex. Yeah, but if it's Munium V and he goes Toxapex and he sets up on that turn, that could potentially just win, because I think Jirachi's offensive. Like, Spadef Jirachi would be able to wall offensive Mew, the Munium Z one. But Scarf Jirachi doesn't wall out that well, especially if it runs Fire Blast. But I actually don't think it's the Munium Z on this team. So there's the Keldeo. I think he expected the Mamoswine, but this is just a free Toxapex. He's gonna try to burn it, I assume, yeah. He does get the burn, so that is really helpful for him because it cancels out the lefties. Ray Scarf has run lefties on his pecs. I think he runs that because in one of his games where his Toxapex got tricked and some of his other mons got tricked, then like Toxapex had Black Sludge, it got tricked to some other mon, and the opposing mon then tricked the Black Sludge to one of others, to one mon on Ray's team, another mon, and then it got hurt by the Black Sludge. I think after that he changed it to lefties. That's at least what I've heard. I think I talked about this before in another video. But yeah, I assume Lioness is gonna try to spin the T-Spike here and go Fortress. It's just looking like Scarf Kel to me. I mean, I said this before, but just making sure, like, it shouldn't. Z-Move Kel usually runs Hydro Pump, Taunt, Calm Mind, and then a Secret Sword, but I think Z-Focus Blast can be really cool. I don't know. Like, I wish we would see that set more. Like, Z-Focus Blast, you Calm Mind on Tangrowth and then you blow it away. Like, Secret Sword, you also, like, beat it. But I think Z-Focus Blast can be really cool. But yeah, Z-Move Keldeo in general is really amazing because it beats packs. You taunt them so they can't haze you. They can Toxic you, and then you set up Calm Minds. The only thing I can do to you is Skull Burn you. So he goes hard on the Zard. I mean, this is fine, but these mons just can't. Zard can't touch the packs. The packs can't really touch the Zard. So unless the packs has Toxic, but it doesn't have. It's probably gonna be Haze, Recover, Scald, and Toxic Spikes. So he just did this to get his Zard more healthy, and I assume now he's gonna go into the Fortress and spin. Like, Ray can just go for Skull and get some chip here. Because if the Fortress would come out, then it can only take like two more Skulls, I think, maybe three. I think it's in 3 HK Orange from Scald in the Sun. The Sun is not up, it's obviously dies way earlier to Scald. But yeah, I've talked about this before in my other video. I have some snake games. Let me know in the comments if you want to see the ABR game versus, I think it was versus Axel 10, because that game just happened just before this one, so I only recorded like the beginning of it. Like I missed like 10 turns or something at the big ending, so I would have to watch those on the replay, but I could record the beginning live. So Fortress is barely able, it was way lower than I thought it was, never mind. My bad, I thought it was like at 18% or 20. So he's gonna be able to get off his spin here, but then he's gonna die to a Scald. And Toxapex easily gets up T-Spikes again later on. But yeah, Lioness might have... I mean, he's eventually gonna die to Scald, and this Toxapex... Like, spin has more PP. So he obviously doesn't get up T-Spikes if he keeps spamming then. So he can just go for Scald and kill this. Not sure why he's not doing that. So that's the Volt into Zarda, I assume. And a Coco, okay. So he's trying to get some other monsters in. I assume he's gonna U-turn here on the Mamoswine slash Ductrio. The only reason you would ever bring up Ductrio on Coco is if you Scarf. Not the only reason, but that would be the main reason. So he goes Duggy, makes me think that he's... Like, I was thinking he Scarf Raichu, but he might also be Scarf Duggy. There's the Keldeo. Ray can just... If he Scarf Duggy, Earthquake plus Poison might actually kill the Keldeo, but he obviously wants to keep that around. So he just makes the save play, goes back in the picks. I was just thinking if he could, if the Keldeo takes more poison and the Duggy is Scarfed, then the Duggy can eventually just revenge the Keldeo. Not the Keldeo is a big problem since he has his pecs, just saying. So I assume we're just gonna see a Scald spam from Ray here, in case Lioness tries to go into Fortress to spin. If he Scalds, that would just kill the Fortress and not let him spin the T-Spike away. Like, usually, the mons like Coco that are only in for a few turns, I think it's better for Lioness if there's only one if there's two T-Spikes. Because if there's two T-Spikes, the poison damage is less at the beginning and gets... the poison racks up over time, but it's less at the beginning. But one T-Spike, I think it does the same amount every round and does a little bit more at the beginning than badly poisoned us, than toxic poisoned us. So I think he should have let up the two T-Spikes go up. But for mons like Mew, obviously for mons like Mew, one T-Spike is better. So actually that makes more sense, yeah. I was just thinking about the Coco and about the Keldeo. If they don't stay in long, then one T-Spike is better. Two T-Spikes are better, that's what I meant. Yeah, two T-Spikes are better for those two. But for the Mew, you obviously, if that's a defensive Mew, you don't want it to be badly poisoned. So in that sense, one would be better. But yeah, like eventually he has to get his mons get poisoned. And if it's physical Coco, the poison helps him in the sense that he can't get burned by Scald. I'd still just go for U-turn here. Like, it's so obvious that he's just gonna go into his Mamo probably. Because I think Duggy dies from U-turn. So he's probably gonna go Mamo here. You U-turn on that. And you get your Zard back in, or your Mew. I don't know. Maybe your Zard, maybe your Mew. Because Keldeo doesn't really do much. Like if you get it in, it just takes poison damage and then Pex comes back out. And Mew could potentially put some pressure, depending on the set. If it has Psychic, if it's defensive Mew, it can beat the Pecs. If it's Minium Z, it obviously easily beats the Pecs. But even if it's defensive, it's Psychic, it can still do a lot. So there's the obvious U-turn on the Mamo, like Chip. Okay, so he's going this route onto Zard, and the Pecs is gonna come back out here, obviously. I'm actually really hungry, I should have eaten before I started this recording, but it's fine. I said Lyanna's time is really low, but he's probably just gonna click the fire move here. Before he times out, I would just click it. Like, it's just a save in case Ray stays in predicting your double switch. And Pick still gets worn down. 36 actually does a good chunk. And Ray's gonna go for recover here. Coco comes back in. Coco can just go for U-turn again. And yeah, like, Lioness's main win con is this Coco, because the ground types, the Dougie and the Mamo, are both getting super low. And Ray won't be able to bring in his ground types on U-turn the entire time. But if he is Scarf Dougie and he sacks something, then he might be able to revenge his Coco. So Ray's like, nah, I've had enough. I'm staying with my packs this time, predicting your U-turn. But that's completely fine for Lioness. Skull doesn't do any damage to Zard. Skull also only has that many PP, so he can kind of stall that out. So if he has Roost on Coco, he can just go back to Coco and Roost. The only problem with that would be if Ray goes hard on the Dougie expecting that Roost. And then he would be able to pick him off with a Scarf off if he Scarf. So I assume we see a Roost here from Lioness. I mean, he could just U-turn again if he doesn't want to risk a Scarf Dougie. But U-turn would make sense here. Like, Roost would make sense is what I'm trying to say. I mean, U-turn. Both plays make sense. But until he doesn't know if the Dougie is Scarf, U-turn probably makes more sense here. Because if you kill the Scarf Dougie here with the U-turn, then your Coco is basically freed up. You can still Roost later on the Toxic Packs after you sack your Fortress. So, like, you don't lose anything from U-turning here if you lay on it. There's the Dougie, and hopefully you made the correct play in U-turning. Yup, Bob Dougie is gone. I'm rooting for Lioness because he's German. I also know that Ray doesn't care about that much about ulti anymore. He got kind of hexed in Runner's Bracket last round. So there's the Pex back in. I assume we're going to see a Tox at the Fortress sack. Or Lioness might also stay in for a few turns trying to waste some more Skull PP from the Pex. And yeah, I've been doing this a lot lately. The music is gonna be in the description again if you guys want it. Because sometimes I only link the channel from the person that makes the song. But yeah, I've been starting to like link the exact track. Sometimes I forget it, but like I do it most of the time. Especially if it's a non-Glitch X City song that most people might like. Because Glitch X City is kind of well known. So it just goes for the Fire Blast. That's waste. Another Scald, and then the Pex rest and another recover, so I can definitely see what Lioness is doing. Now, like I said, he was sacking his Fortress, and now he can get in his Coco and Roost. This is what I was talking about. Like, I'm pretty sure he just has a Roost. And it's just the Wild Charge, U-turn, Roost, and Taunt slash HP. I said probably Taunt, because Ray likes to use Stall, so it makes a lot of sense that he brought this type of Coco. I'm pretty sure Ray was Scarf on his Dougie, and he tried to catch him on the Roost like on the Roost with the Coco, and then goes on the Dougie and tries to trap it. Like, at first I wasn't sure if he Scarf Raji or Scarf Coco, but the way he played that, I think he was Scarf Dougie. Jirachi could be Spidef on his team. Jirachi could be Spidef since his Magnezone was Specs, because his team actually gets destroyed by Specs later, so that makes sense now that I look at his team. So that's the Roost. T-Specs go back up, which makes a lot of sense that he wants them up to poison the Mew. The Mew isn't poisoned yet. Coco and Keldeo already are. Lioness can just Roost again here. You can also U-turn here, because Ray needs this Pex for the Zard. If the Pex dies, Zard kind of just wins. Even though Fire Blast only has like 6 PP left, and Fire Blast can technically miss. But you guys get what I'm saying, like 6 Fire Blasts left. So he just sacks it. The crit obviously sucks. I think he would have lived that. So I think Ray tried to catch him on a U-turn there. But overall, this Coco was just gonna win in the long run. And yeah, like, Ray didn't bring his usual stall team, but Coco, this Coco that is good with the stalls to put in the work with him. Like, Skull from Pax wouldn't have killed. The Coco could have roosted next turn. Then Lioness could have still U-turned. And then he could have just gone into Zard, get the Sun back up so Skull does no damage to his, the rest of his team. Like, it's not like Pax was really doing too much versus him. Like, it was walling the Zard. This is one of the reasons why I like Toxic on Pax. It's really nice for Zard. It's nice for Mew. It's nice for Zapdos. So you guys just get some chip with Ice Shard, but this game is over. Zard clicks Fire Blast on Jirachi, and the game should end. Oh, it is actually Shiny Jirachi. My bad, guys. So it is the Happy Hour Jirachi. At Team Preview, I thought it didn't show that it's Shiny. Maybe I just saw it wrong. I actually go back and check after the series, when the series is over. Actually, I'm gonna pause it real quick before we watch Game 2. And see if it was Shiny at Team Preview. I could have sworn I see that it looked like non-Shiny at Team Preview. Maybe it's just because the sun is shining into my room and looks a bit weird. Not 100% sure about that. Well, I'll definitely check that. Yeah, this game is over. I don't know why Ray is like taking his time here. I guess he can be happy. Yeah, actually, Ray can still win this. If it's not Spadev, like I thought first. He can go for the Happy Hour, and if he dodges a Fire Blast, he can still win. Because he can easily flinch down the Mew, and I think the Heart Stamp will kill the Keldeo, and the Coco is also kind of in range from that, yeah. So if he dodges a Fire Blast here, there's no justice. This is a Speed Tap, by the way. So Ray might also just go for the Iron Head Flinch. Oh, he just go for the Iron Head Flinch. And he does the Fire Blast, so no flinch there. Not sure. Why didn't he go? Is he not the Happy Hour? He was Shiny, right? He looked like Shiny. If he's the Happy Hour there, I think his chances. I kind of understand why he made the play, because if he the chances of getting the flinch are higher than getting dodging a Fire Blast, so I can understand why he made that play, because he can still set up a Happy Hour after on. Actually, no, he can't because the Coco has taunt. Okay, game 2 already started. Ray brings a stall that he used in World Cup with no Dougie. I think Dougie without stall is really, really bad. Let me just pause it real quick and see a team preview of game 1 if he was Shiny Jirachi. Yeah, I was about to say, like, at preview he wasn't Shiny, but later he was Shiny, so I wasn't wrong. Yeah, interesting that it doesn't show that the team preview. Really weird to me. But yeah, let me pause you again and we're gonna be back with game 2. I'm just gonna talk about something real quick again. So I said his team is super weak to Lily and I thought he was Spadev Jirachi. But yeah, he still had this duck tree, so obviously he's not that weak to Lily because his busted Mondaggy with Arena Trap was still allowed in this round of ulti. So let me go game two and watch that. Let me skip forward. Okay, there we go. So yeah, we see our interesting team. Mega Pinsir plus Magnezone, love that core. Especially now that Arena Trap is banned, it's pretty nice. I'm not saying it's broken or anything, but it can definitely put in some nice work. Since Celesteela is so good at the moment, like, why not use Magnezone plus Pinsir? It seems fire. The only thing I hate about Pinsir, and like, Pinsir, Zard, all those Megas, they're weak to Rock, so you always have to run reliable hazard control, and you're gonna be defogging a lot of the time, so it's hard to get up rocks on the other side. Not the biggest fan of that. But yeah, the Muk is probably AV, the Arthur is probably the Belly Drum. He could still be Z-Move Lando, but he's, because he has probably a fast Mew with Ice Beam to check Zygarde already, so the Lando could be Z-Move, and the Arthur could be Citrus, but it could also be the Belly Drum Arthur. But yeah, this team was used by Ray in World Cup, like I said. It's Dougie-less, it's that white stall basically. Dougie-less stall, I don't think it's good at all because like it gets annoyed by Heatran a lot, and there's like a lot of other ones that trouble stall without Dougie. And when Dougie was allowed, and he sacks his Zard turn 1 to Scarf Lando, wow. I didn't even consider Scarf Lando, but he just got, oh god, the game just got a lot easier for my man Lioness. I don't know why I called him a man, I don't really know him. I've recorded with him before, but I don't know him too much. I've recorded with him because I think Advanced Ship knew him, and I've recorded with Advanced Ship in some SPL games. But yeah. I didn't even talk about Scarf Lando because I just know that Ray likes fat teams, so I just thought Lioness would focus on bringing breakers, but you obviously still have to consider that Ray can use something that is not star. So Scarfer makes a lot of sense. So it might be Scarf, Rocks, Lando on Lioness' team. Because the Mew is gonna have to be Defog. Yeah, I think it's Scarfrog's Landudan. That's why I didn't consider Scarf, because Scarfrog just seems so weird. I know I've seen it before and talked about it before, but it doesn't come to mind at first when I think about Lando. So he doubles out predicting the Toxapex into a Landorus, nice play there. Toxapex is the only one that Drake, like, that was his only play there. Because he obviously not, you don't want to lose the lefties on any of your other mons, you don't want to lose the Valet on your Chansey. So if he gets the burn, that would suck, but he didn't get it. So he goes for Scarf Rocks there, so Ray can stay in here. He obviously doesn't have to fear anything. He can just go for Scalding Fish on a burn or whatever he goes to. But he just goes for T-Spikes. Yeah, that's not the end of the world, since he has a Muk. He doubles into Muk just to immediately get rid of the T-Spike. There's a Recover. There's the knockoff on the lefties. Interesting that he doesn't carry Shed Shell. He carries his lefties on all his Pexes. There's a burn on the Muk, but that was about to happen since he has been using Scald a few times. He was obviously going to get a burn sooner or later. Oh, I thought he would go for T-Spikes, but he goes for Scald again. Potentially expected Lioness to go into Landorus there. Obviously, his zone works too. So he's going to Volt Switch here. I assume we're going to see the Chansey come out. Obviously. There's the Discharge. Okay. Haven't seen Discharge Zone in forever. Let's see if he's AV or if he's Specs. 15%, it kind of looks like Specs, to be honest, since Chansey is really fat on the Spidef side. With the Violet and all that goodness. So I think we're gonna see a Seismic Toss slash Toxic from Chansey here. Pinsir kind of destroys Ray Scarvis as well. Well, Pinsir looks so scary. But he has to play it well. He can just go hard into it, obviously. So he goes in the Muk. The Toxapex is going to come out here, obviously, again. So I think Ray could... Leonis could double again on Toxapex. Either into Magnus or into Lando. He goes into Lando, yep. So I can see him clicking U-turn here on the predicting the Mew slash something else, but he does stay in with the Pegs. I don't know why he stayed in. He crits, he goes for Earthquake and crits a Toxapex. That speeds up the game a lot. It obviously sucks. But like if you lose the defensive teams and like you're always on the defense, you use your recovery moves and you stay in on the offensive moves, you're gonna get crit eventually. But it still sucks. If Ray burnt the Lando there, like I still don't like that he sanked his Zard Y turn one. Like you should always scout for Scarf Lando in my opinion. Maybe I'm not 100% sure about this. I know when electric terrain or like terrains go up before intimidate, it means that the Tapus are faster. But I'm not sure if intimidate and sun works the same way, because if intimidate and sun works the same way, then Ray could have known that it was Scarf Lando turn 1, and then he might have predicted Lioness to not go for edge. But if you know the Lando is Scarf, even if you know the Lando is Scarf, you never stay in with your Zard. So this is an interesting set. I'm not really a big fan of Unaware Clef with Calm Mind. I've never seen this. I've used this in Auras myself, but I don't like it. I would consider myself really bad in Auras when I used like semi-stolen stole sometimes. I wasn't really good in Auras at all. I'm not saying I'm great now, but I'm definitely a bit better now. He's obviously gonna be spamming Flash Cannon here. Ray's gonna Calm Mind again here so he can eat it up better. Protect Frost is actually the better play to get more leftovers, yeah. So the Heal Bell user is gonna be the Chansey, not the Clef. Since this is Calm Mind. I mean, it's nice to have a Wincon on stall, don't get me wrong. But on Clef, you usually need the healing ability. Oh, it's Corkscrew Crash. Ooh, goodbye. But yeah, if you guys know if the Sun and Intimidate tells you to... If you can find out like that, if the Lando is Scarf, I don't think you can. I'm actually going to go back to turn 1 again and check after. I don't think it tells you anything like that. But if you guys know about it, let me know. But I'm pretty sure it doesn't tell you. So at this point, it doesn't matter. Pretty much Pinsir wins the game. Arthur can get up a Belly Drum also on the Chansey and gets a kill. The crit on the packs obviously sucked. Ray could have still won this game. But I'm not saying that Ray won't guarantee. Like, Leon has definitely had some ways to like put in work with his team. So he's gonna be sacking his lander here. I assume this is just a helmet tank. Since we have seen flea powder. Yep. So the tank just goes for Giga there on the dead Lando. And Pinsir gets a kill here. There's no point in SDing up though. I'm not sure if he has to go Pinsir here. Maybe, yeah, exactly. He can like go into Pinsir later. So he's just gonna click knockoff here. Yeah, that did so much. I think that's a fast Mew for sure. Oh, that's actually, is that bandit damage? That might be bandit Azu, yeah. So even if the Mew goes for Will-O-Wisp, it's gonna die to the next knockoff, I'm pretty sure. I know that knockoff is weaker the second time when the Mew loses the item, but still, it's obviously gonna die. If he goes back to Tangrowth, I think he might still get to a kill. So he's trying to soft bulk. Okay, it's belly drum. So this was just a super fast Mew without any bulk, or with like little bulk in defense. Probably just max HP. I don't know why he didn't like wisp there. There was like not really a point in soft bulking, I feel. But maybe I'm missing something. He had to bank on Lioness choking, I guess. But yeah, that's the Aqua Jet weakening the Tang. Actually, only the 28. Why didn't he knock off? Oh, he just wants to win with Pinsir. Yeah, okay. He just wants to go out winning with Pinsir. I don't think it mattered at the end there. He could have just won with Azu. And yeah, Chansey is gonna get blown away. I mean, Chansey actually might live this. Yeah, Chansey eats it up. But he can go for SD here. Yep. And then Chansey is not gonna eat it up anymore. Now the Chansey is gonna get super low. And bop. It's a toxic. And he can frustration, quick attack, whatever here. So Leon is wins 2-0. He's still in ulti round 3, loses bracket. And Ray Scarface is out of the tour. I actually forgot who Lioness is facing for this round of loser's bracket. I'm gonna pause real quick and look that up. And I'm also gonna go back to this scenario with the Zardwire real quick and try to figure that out. Oh yeah, obviously. The Zard isn't Megard, so like we don't know that. Like, so they both come out and the Intimidate obviously goes up and it's not Megard yet. But if Zardwire would start in its Mega form, I think we would be able to tell. I'm not sure. So like, let's say if. So I said this wrong earlier because I completely forgot that the Zard doesn't have the Mega Turn 1. But let's say both players lose in 1 on a double down, and then one player goes into Scarf Land and one player goes into Zard Y. So then the Sun should go up and the Intimidate should go up. And I think I'm not 100% sure if you can tell from that if which one is faster. If you guys know, let me know. And let me pause real quick and look up who Lioness is facing for ulti round 3 loser's bracket. He's gonna be playing updated Kanto, so that's a fire series. Stay tuned for that the next days. Other series that are gonna be coming, Kick Ezza versus my man Sorry. Yeah, I already uploaded the other series that happened for round 3. I don't think I missed any. For round 2, I missed a lot of the series. I missed Meeps versus Farden. I missed Empo versus Suchtres. I think Bushrush was Ashquaz. I recorded game 2 live, but that day I didn't really feel like I missed a bit of game 1 and I didn't really feel like re-narrating that, so I just decided to not upload that series. But yeah, you guys can see I'm pumping out the content, and for me it's like way more fun to live narrate. Like, now I had to re-narrate over an old video that I already did, but it's still basically live, so I hope you guys still enjoy this. In general, like, the only reason why I do this is because, on that Sunday, like I said earlier, I was super tired. So I just felt like only let it record, and I was like, let me just rewrite this next week. And I hope you guys enjoyed. This was the last OLT series, if I recall correctly, that I recorded for round 2. But yeah, I'm gonna be back with more round 3 games, and I'm gonna be back, I have more Snake games for you guys. So stay tuned for that. And I'm happy that Lioness could move on to round 3 loser's bracket. And peace out, have a fantastic day. Bob Dokch out. I don't know what that weird outro was. Good God, that was weird.